My name is Chris Ward, member of the Gabelli Funds Growth Equity Team. Today I wanted to highlight a few of our high-level takeaways coming out of the most recent quarter from our consumer internet names. In e-commerce, Amazon's investments in one-day shipping bore fruit in Q4, driving strong top-line growth in the online retail business. Amazon's one-day shipping offering is raising the bar yet again for competing retailers, who will either lose market share or be forced to match Amazon's offering at the expense of margins. Amazon's ability to offer one-day shipping on 30 million SKUs should also shed light on the competitive advantage Amazon has built by integrating its online marketplace platform with its physical infrastructure and logistics network. Amazon's better-than-expected margins in Q4 can be attributed to a mixed shift away from first-party retail and towards higher-margin third-party sellers, cloud, and advertising. Speaking of advertising, ad budgets continue to flow to digital advertising platforms. Amazon's ad business grew 40% year-over-year, and we estimate is now at a run rate of about $15 billion. Amazon is uniquely positioned to offer advertisers a closed feedback loop from ad purchase to consumption. GOOGL, again, showed consistent execution at scale with FX-neutral revenue growth of 19%. For the first time, GOOGL disclosed ad revenue for YouTube, which grew 36% year-over-year to $15 billion. Combining these new disclosures with our estimate of 2 billion YouTube monthly average users, we can estimate that average revenue per user on YouTube is only $7 or $8, which suggests a long runway for monetization when you consider Facebook's $30 global ARPU. At Facebook, revenue growth decelerated over 400 basis points quarter over quarter to 25%. We expect another mid-single digit deceleration in Q1. Facebook is facing ad revenue headwinds from a variety of sources, including product changes from browser providers, Facebook's own product changes that allow users to limit the data Facebook collects on third-party sites, and ad targeting headwinds from GDPR in Europe, and more recently from the Consumer Privacy Act in California. However, the most important metric of platform health at Facebook, user engagement, remains strong, even on the most mature product, core Facebook Blue. Daily average users on core Facebook, not including Instagram or WhatsApp, grew 9% globally and accelerated over the course of the year. Engagement, as measured by daily actives as a percent of monthly actives, remained strong and stable at 66%. Management noted that Facebook newsfeed was a primary contributor to ad impression growth for the second quarter in a row. As impression growth begins to slow, we expect pricing to return to growth as the supply-demand dynamics of the ad auction improve. In total, Facebook's family of products now reach 2.9 billion people monthly, and nearly 80% of those are active on a daily basis. Last but not least, digital media conglomerate IAC provided some additional color around its proposed spin for its 81% interest in Match Group, which should be completed in Q2. IAC is our preferred way to invest in the Match asset, which owns a portfolio of dating apps, most popular being Tinder. IAC also maintains an 84% interest in publicly traded Angi Home Services. Marking to market IAC's stake in Match and Angi implies a negative $1 billion value for IAC's stub assets, which include Vimeo, Dotdash, and Care.com. We view the upcoming spin of Match as a catalyst to narrow that discount. A recurring theme across the consumer internet space that has once again been brought to the forefront due to the upcoming election is regulation. We continue to monitor the regulatory landscape closely, especially as we consider a national rollout of California's Consumer Privacy Act as inevitable. The state-by-state patchwork of regulations is simply too burdensome for an industry built on bits of data that flow freely and effortlessly across state lines. Who's most vulnerable to data privacy restrictions? It would appear to be Facebook, given they do not rely on contextualized search the way Google and Amazon do through keyword search. The good news is Facebook preemptively rolled out compliant privacy settings globally. And ultimately, we believe data privacy regulation will only entrench the walled gardens who have billions of logged-in, authentic users. 2 years have passed since the implementation of GDPR in Europe, and Facebook and Google have only gained share at the expense of small ad tech players who do not have the resources to comply, much less remain going concerns.